Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jumper.
Basically, you start out with massive amounts of data. Say, how are we going to analyze this? Well, let's fire up a pivot table and see if we can solve this problem. Hey, all right, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jellin. Today, a tip. This is sent in from Australia. Rod sent in this tip, and he said, you know, I saw this back in episodes 484, 45, 46. I would never have a use for this in real life, but Rod came up with a great use for using index. But Rod takes this to the next level. I want to talk about a couple of functions before we talk about the index function and introduce you to the problem. I'm going to talk about the row function. So I'm just going to come here and say equal row, and then open and close parenthesis. Press Control Enter, and you see that what the row function does is it tells you what row that cell is in. So if you don't specify any reference in the row function, it, you know, basically is just giving you the numbers 1 through 10. And if I would insert a new row, everything automatically updates. So it's a nice, great way of seeing which row you're in. A similar function is the column function. So we'll just select some data here, equal column, Control Enter, and it shows you which column you're in. Okay. All right. So here's Rod's problem. Every day, he's getting a CSV file from somewhere, and whoever creates the CSV file is creating it wrong, right? Because Rod needs the months going across, lines going down. And you and I know that for us to go back to whoever's creating that and say, hey, change your program, right, it'll take months before they ever get to it. So every day, Rod was taking this data and doing an edit, paste, special, transpose to turn it sideways. But the problem is that Rod then had to reformat the report. He had all kinds of color patterns and things like that. So here was Rod's solution. He used the index function, equal index, and he said, I want the index of this data back here on the CSV file. Okay, now index is kind of obscure. What we have to say now is which row we want and which column we want. Well, what Rod did is for the row information, he asked for the current column. And for the column information, he asked for the current row, put closing parentheses there. And when we copy this throughout, you'll see that it takes the data and transposes it perfectly. But because we're doing it with a formula, then any formatting that Rod does, that formatting stays put. So all he has to do is paste the new data back into the CSV report. These very cool index functions that use column and row automatically turn the data sideways. It's a beautiful thing when you can use one formula and copy it throughout your report, and it works everywhere. I want to thank Rod for sending in this excellent tip. I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.
Well, thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.